One. Good morning to you. Today is Wednesday. It is October the 27th, and I am your host, the Troublemaker Extraordinaire, coming to you recorded from the comforts of my lazy boy recliner here at Wake Up Central with the Wednesday edition of the Morning Wake Up Call. Well, it is most definitely Wednesday. We are halfway there. There's only a few days left in the week, and then we'll land feet first right into another weekend, and I hope you have some big plans. I do. I've got some large plans for the weekend. I cannot wait. By the way, just to give you a heads up, there will not be a TGI Friday show this week. We shall more than likely roll the headline show to Thursday, which will be tomorrow, and then there will be no show on Friday. But anyway, at the moment, I have one thing and one thing only on my mind. And that is, I am happier than a roll of duct tape being used to tape together duct work. And I tell you what, friends, that is happiness. And yes, duct tape can be used for duct work. I'm just saying. All right, now let's take a look at the weather forecast for the Jackson-Madison County metro area and see what's in store for us today. We are looking at mostly sunny skies. The highs are going to be in the lower 80s, and tonight, partly cloudy. The low will be in the mid-40s. All right, boys and girls, I have a wonderful show lined up for you today. I have an informational show that we're going to do, and today's show is sunglasses. Yes, it is. If your idea of sunglass shopping is trying a variety of pair of sunglasses and gazing off into a mirror, well, these instructions will take you to a whole new level, because there are more to sunglass shopping than just good looks. Have you ever thought about the UV protection, the durability, or the visibility? All right, step number one, you have to protect your eyes. Yes, sir. Excessive exposure to UV radiation can cause a variety of problems for your eyes, such as cataracts, burns, and cancer. If you want your sunglasses to protect you from these risks, look for a pair of sunglasses that block at least 99% of the UVB rays and 95% of the UVA rays. If they are labeled as cosmetic or do not provide any UV protection, then I suggest you do not buy them. Alright, next tip. Choose your color wisely. The color of the lenses don't just affect your fashion statement, it also affects how well you detect and decipher certain colors. Some colors enhance contrast, while others can be useful, and however, these are often expensive color distinctions. They can cause problems for you when you're driving or when you need to be able to see differentiate colors in traffic. So sunglasses even come with interchangeable lenses, so you can change the colors easily depending on what you are doing. Just for an example here, a gray lens is used to reduce light intensity without affecting the contrast or distorting the color. A brown lens particularly enhances contrast by blocking some blue light. They're good for snow sports and also generally good for hunting in bright light against an open background. The amber or yellow lenses significantly enhance contrast because they block out most of all the blue light, and they're very popular amongst hunters. They are bad for activities that color distinction is important, such as driving. So don't wear your yellow glasses when you're driving, okay? They are great for snow sports. You know, there are several other different lens colors, and they affect different things. So make sure that when you're picking out your sunglasses, check out the lens color and make sure that they are appropriate for the type of activity you're going to be wearing these glasses to do. Next tip, consider the lens material. Scratch-up sunglasses are useless sunglasses. Lenses from the NXT polyurethane are impact-resistant, flexible, and lightweight, and have a great optical clarity, but they are expensive. Glass is heavier, expensive, and they're expensive and they will spider if they break. Polycarbonate is not so scratch resistant and provides less optical clarity than the NXT polyurethane or glass, but it's also more affordable. Acrylic is also very affordable, but is less durable. Next tip, decide on your style. Sunglasses come in all shapes and sizes, and here are just a few of the styles. You have the mirror shades that has the mirror coating on the surface, used a lot by law enforcement and military. They usually come in aviator or wraparound shape. There are the aviator or the teardrop style lenses, particularly on the thin metal frame, kind of as the ones I have on currently, often used by pilots and military personnel, law enforcement personnel in the United States. They are good with any face shape, but they are best with an oval face shape. Let's see, the Wayfarers were popular in the 1950s to 1960s. They were worn by Audrey Hepburn in the 1961 movie Breakfast at Tiffany's. You have the T-shades, popularized by John Lennon and Ozzy Osbourne. They are not very effective at keeping the light out of your eyes. Then you also have the wraparounds, which are associated with athletes in extreme sports. Then the oversized sunglasses that are associated with models and movie stars. The last tip is to make sure that the glasses fit snugly and properly. Try them on. Make sure they do not pinch around your head. The weight should be evenly distributed between your ears and your nose. And your eyelashes should not touch the frames or the lenses. All right, so there you go. 5 tips to help you pick out that perfect pair of sunglasses. It's what I do. I'm the purveyor of non-pertinent information, and so here we go. Quote of the day. The best way to get approval is to not need it. That comes from Hugh McLeod. Thank you, Mr. McLeod, for that quote. The best way to get approval is to not need it. I guess that's the reason why I very rarely need approval, but I sure get a heck of a lot of it. Well, no, wait a minute. I get a lot of disapproval. Never mind. Useless information. If you drop a raisin in a fresh glass of soda, it will bounce up and down continually from the top to the bottom of the glass. There you go. Useless info. Well, boys and girls, that is it for today's show. I hope you have enjoyed the show just as much as I have putting it together and getting it on the air for you. Before we get out of here, you know what the lawyers make me do. It's called the Legal Mumbo Jumbo. The views and opinions expressed on the show are those of the host, guest, and fans, not necessarily those of any organization represented by these individuals. Wake Up Calls, production, free speech, communications may be replayed at any time for your viewing pleasure. The contents of the show are meant to only be entertaining and possibly sarcastic. Should you have any issues regarding the show, you are accursed for reading and all comments to my Facebook account. Well, boys and girls, that is it. That is today's show. I hope you have a wonderful day. I will be right back here tomorrow for the Thursday edition of Wake Up Call Headlines tomorrow. But as for now, I like the inverted belly button. I'm out of here.